Hey everyone, in this video I'm going to be showing you how to make this multicolored outline effect. So here I have 5 different colors and you can have many more colors if you want. So here if I press the left mouse button, I can get this outline to show, and if I press it again it will go away, and here also, and here like that. So you can control a lot of things with this. So here I can control the color like this, and I can change the black one to a white color like this. I can also control the outline thickness like this, or 5 or 3. And now I can also change the outline colors of this actor by just changing the stencil value. So if I change this to 1, I will get this green color, and if I change this to 3, I will get this pink color. You can also have these stripes moving upwards on the object like this. And like this. We can also control a lot of parameters. So here I can reduce the power. So if I do that, the lines will get thicker, and if I increase the power, the lines will get thinner. Now I can also control the amount of lines like this. By changing this lines value. We can also control the speed of the lines. So here with this panel, we can also control the speed of the line. You can also create a parameter to control the speed. So I can change this to 0. And if I click apply, you get static lines like this. So here we can also make this work with mouse click. So if I click, it appears there, and click. So now if I click this, the outlines appear, and if I click again, it will disappear like this. And here also like that. So this is what we are going to be making today. And if you want to download the entire project file, you can support me on my Patreon. And for $5, you can download this and almost all my previous project files. The links will be in the description below. And if you don't want to use Patreon and still want to support me, you can now do that by using my Epic Creator tag when you purchase something from the Epic Game Store. And if you use my code, I get a small commission from that. So if that's something you want to do, you can also check that out also. So in order to have multicolored outline, you need to go to settings, then project settings. Then here type in custom depth. Then go to custom depth stencil path and change this to enable with stencil. And that's all you have to do here. Now you can close that. Now we will create our material. So right click, then go to material. Then I will call this m_outlines. Then open it up. Now select this and change the material domain to postprocess. We are going to use a postprocess material to create our outlines. Now right click and type in scene depth. Then get a scene depth node like this, and connect this to the MC color and click apply. And now I will just create a material instance. And now I will go to the postprocess volume. If you don't have it, you can just type in postprocess here and bring that into the world. And kind of make sure that it is enabled and infinite extent is ticked. Then go to the postprocess material, then add an element. Then add this outline. So now it kind of looks like this. So now I will just divide this, and I will connect this to the MC color, and I will get a scalar parameter by pressing and holding S and clicking, and I will name this divide. And now I will connect this to B and click apply. And now if I open the instance and increase the divide value by 10,000. Now here you can see that we have this fog kind of thing, and everything that is close to the camera is black or darker, and the skybox is white because it is far away, and the wall there is also kind of grayish color because it is also far away. And if we move close to them, you can see that it will get darker. So the scene depth is basically the distance between the camera and the objects in the scene. So here, in order to create an outline, so if you look at this cube here, you can see that it's top side. There is a very big change in the value of the colors here at the top, at the left side, and at the right side. So we can hear at the edges there is a big fall off from the black value to the gray value. So we need to dictate these changes around the edges to create a line around them. So here also you can see that there is a very big difference between the color of the sphere and the color of its background. We need to dictate that change in gradient and draw outline around it. So in order to do that, we can go to our material, then we can get something called a scene texel size node, then we will get a multiply, then we will get a screen position node. So this will basically gives us the UV of the screen. So if I connect this to the MC and click apply, so here you can see that we have a UV gradient. It goes from one value to green here to one for green and red, and here both of the green and red values are zero, and here the red value is one and the green value is zero. We will just mask this between R and G and connect this to A and connect this to B. Now we will just duplicate our scene depth node here, and we will connect this to the UVs. So in order to get the outlines, we need to sample from the top, from the left, from the right, and from down, and also the center pixels. So here first we will get the center pixel. So for that we need to multiply this with the kernel value for outlines, which is -4. And here for this B of the multiply, we will get the center pixel, which is 0, 0. Now to get the pixel from the left, we can actually duplicate all of this and just change this value to 1. For R. So this will get us the pixel from the right direction. And if you give -1 here and 0 to the green, we will get the pixel from the left direction. And we can just duplicate this and go on like that. So there's an easier way to get this pixel offset values. So to get that, you can just right click and type in blur, then blur sample offset. Now if I open this up, we get one for the right direction, we get one for the left direction, and we get one for the top and bottom direction. And here we also have this offset amount, which we will use to increase the size of our outlines. So here we can get all of these pixel offsets from this one material function, this blur sample offset. So you can just delete this and connect this here. And just duplicate this and connect this to here and duplicate this again and connect this to here and duplicate this again. And connect this to here. Now we will just add all of them together like this. So you can add this and add this. So here I have connected 0, 1 for the top direction, and 10 for the right, and 0, negative 1 for the bottom, and negative 1, 0 for the left direction. So we are sampling all 4 directions. So now we will just add all of them together. And we will add this together also. And now finally we need to add this to this center pixel value. So I will just add this here. And now if I connect this to the MSC color. So now you can see that we get this outline, but our world is kind of shaking violently. In order to fix this, we can select this and here we can type in blend. Then before tone mapping and click apply. So now we have this outline. So now in order to clean this outlines up, we can use a node called flow. So type in flow, and if I connect this to the MSC, so here what this flow node does is that every value which is lower than 1 will be changed to 0. So it will kind of clean up the outlines a bit like this. So now we have outlines like this. And if you want the outlines and just the world, you can just connect this to the alpha, then connect this to MSC color and give a color here. I will give a value of 2 for R for a red color, and for the layer A, I will just type in scene texture and change this to postprocess input 0, and I will just mask this and also tick B. So this will give us our original color, and if I connect this to the alpha and connect this to A, we can get the outline. Now here we also need to clamp this. Now we got our outlines, but there is this weird effect going on with the skybox. So in order to fix this, remember when I first connected the scene depth to the MSC color, the skybox had a very big value. We can use that to mask out the skybox. So in order to do that, I will just get the scene depth and I will get an if node. And I will connect this here. And here I will give a maximum value. And I will change this to like 10,000. And if scene depth is greater than this max value, then we will output a value of 1. I mean 0. And if it is smaller than B, we will output a value of 1. So now if I just connect this to B and connect this here and connect this here and connect this to the MSC color and click apply. We only have outlines on our world and the sky is fixed. Now we will create our multicolored outlines. So before that, I will just rearrange them. I will just select all of this and comment it, and I will call this outlines, and I will just bring it here, and this will be our normal color, and this is a sky mask. We don't really need this for this tutorial, so I will just disconnect it and I will make it go here. So in order to highlight selected object from the world, we need to create a custom depth mask. So for that, right click and type in scene texture. Then change this to custom depth. Then duplicate this and change this to scene depth. Now we need to subtract the scene depth from the custom depth, and we only need the arch channel here. Now we will just clamp this and seal this so we have an integer number, and connect this to the MC color and click apply. So here if I just bring in this cube and if I type in custom depth and if I just tick render in custom depth, it will be black. So this will give us our mask to highlight this object. Now in order to have different colored objects, we need different values for this mask. So for that we can use a node called custom stencil node. So if I just duplicate this custom depth and change this to custom stencil, and now I will just select the custom stencil and I will connect this to the MC color and click apply. And here you can see that it is black. If I give a custom depth stencil value of 1, it will be white, and if I give it a value of 255, it will be very bright, and 100. So with this I can select this particular object and note other objects which are in the custom depth. So here you can see that this is at custom depth value of 2, and this is at 1, and this is also, and this is at 3. So this is what gave us our 3 different colors when I started this tutorial. So we can use this to mask out different values. So in order to mask out different values, we can just mask this with the arch channel. We only need the arch channel. Now we will use a material function called bitmask. This bitmask will allow us to just give a bit here, and if that bit value matches the value of the custom stencil of the object, it will be white and not really glowing like that, but just the value white. So if I open it up, you can see that here it is getting divided by 255. So here we need to divide this by 255 also, and I will connect this to the bit mask, and for the value of the bit I will get a constant value by pressing and holding 1 and clicking, and I will change this value to 1, and I will connect this to the bit, and I will connect this to MC color, and if I click apply, and if I just bring in a cube like this and render it in custom depth, and if I change this value to 1, it will be white, but at value 2 it will be black, but at 1 it will be white. So now if I change this bit value to 50 and click apply, here it is black, but if I change this value to 50, it is white. So we can use the custom stencil value and also the custom depth value to mask out different objects in the world. So now I will just select all of this and comment this custom depth mask. Now I will just call this bit mask. Then I will bring it here and I will change this value to 1, and I will just duplicate this, both of this, and bring it here, and I will just connect this here and change this value to 2, duplicate this again, and I will change this value to 3. So now in order to outline just the objects with the custom depth values, we can just 1 minus this, and get a layer, and connect this to the MC color, and connect this to alpha, then connect this normal color here, and connect this to the B here. So now if I click apply, we can see that only objects with the custom depth mask has this red color. So if I add this to the custom depth, it will also have this red color. Now to increase the thickness of this outline, we can go to the outline, then go here and get a scalar parameter, and I will call this thickness, and I will connect this to the offset amount, and I will default this to 1, and I will click apply. And now if I go to the instance, I can change the thickness to 2 or like 4 or maybe 3. I think 2 is better. And now I can also change the color like this. I can also increase the brightness of the colors. So now we will give different colors to the different custom stencil values. For that, I will just disconnect this and get two layers and connect this to A and connect this to B here. And I will connect this to the alpha. So we can also get one more layer and connect this to A. And I will connect this to alpha here and connect this to the alpha here. So here we have to connect this here. So when it is selecting 1, everything else will be 0. So we will get the color from B. So this will be color 0. And I will just duplicate this. And this will be color 1. And duplicate that again. And this will be color 2. Connect this here. Connect this here. And now I will just change this to color 3. So when the object has a custom stencil value of 3, we will get this color 3 as output. And everything else will be 0. So we will get the colors from these layers. So now if I click apply, and if I change this to black, and I change this to green, and increase the value like this, and I will just change this color to white. Now if I just select this, and by changing the custom stencil value, I can change the color. 0 will give this blue color, this one. And 1 will give this black color. Like this. So if you want more colors like this, you can just add it here like this. And this is all you need to do. So I will just bring all of them here. And I will just bring it here also. And now I will just select all of this and call this colors. Now we will create the actors to get this selection effect like this. So for that, I will go to the content browser, then I will just right click, then blueprint class, then actor, then BP, outlines, then open it up. Then I will get a cube here. And now make sure that here the visibility channel is set to block in collision. Then go to the event graph, then right click and type in custom event. Then we will call this activate. And now just drag the cube in, and here type in set custom depth and tick this. And now drag again and type in set custom depth stencil value, then we will just promote this to a variable and we will just call this value. So now I will just expose this so we can edit it in the map. And now I will just duplicate this. And here I will just type in custom. And with this custom event, I will call this deactivate. So here when we call activate, it will set the cube to custom depth and also set the custom depth stencil value to this value. And when we call deactivate, it will stop rendering the cube in custom depth. So uncheck this value also. Click compile. And I will just delete all of this. And I will just bring in the cube. Now I can select the cube and kind of change the custom stencil value. So nothing will happen because it isn't activated yet. So in order to activate this, we need to go to the first person character. So from here, I will just get this left mouse button event. We can also find this by typing in left mouse button. Now get this sphere and type in get world location. Now right click and type in line trace by channel and connect this here. So what this line trace by channel does is that it will just create a laser from this start location to the end location, and if it hit anything, we can access all of its properties from this hit results. So for the start location, we need this sphere location here. We will start it from this location. And for the end location, we need to get the forward vector. So this will just tell us which way the sphere is facing. And we can just multiply with a float. Since this is a unit vector, whichever direction it is facing, we are going to extend that by this many units. So I will just change that units to 1000. Now we can add this to this world location. So it will start from this location and extends 1000 units from that. And we will connect this to the end. Now we will get a branch and connect this here and connect this to the condition. And we can just break this. And here we will type in cast to outlines and then connect hit actor to objects. Then here we can just call activate and click compile. So when the first time we hit the actor, the activate will be called and the outline will be rendered. And the second time we need to deactivate this. So here I will just get a flip flop. So the first time the output will go from A and the second time it will go from B. You can either connect this here or you can just call deactivate. And now click compile. And if I press play, now if I press, we can have this outline like this. So now, in order to make this work with the mouse cursor, we can go to the first person character. Then here add a sequencer and get a player controller and set show mouse cursor and tick this so we can see our mouse cursor in game. And then we will just disconnect this and here just get a player controller and type in get hit result under cursor by channel, then split it and just create a branch. And here we will just cast this to our BP outlines. So type in cast to BP outlines and connect this here. And we need to call activate. Now if I compile and press play, if I press it, I can activate it like this. So I can also duplicate this and change this value to 3 I can get this white outlines. I will change this value to like 1. So I will just change the outline colors here. I will change this to like this pink color. So now I will change this blue color to this color, and I will change the white color to a black color. Now I can get this orange color if I press it, and if I press this, I can get a different color. Now to create that overlay sprites, type in linear gradient. So this will basically give us a gradient, and now I will get a scalar parameter and call this lines, and this will control the number of lines. So I will just connect this to B, then I will change this to 10. Now I will get a frac node. So with this I can just control the lines. So if I give it 4, there will be less lines, and if I give it 10, there will be more lines. You can also achieve this effect by using a texture if you want. Now just type in cosine, so it will give us lines like this. Now we will get a power node, so we can control the size of the lines. So I will call this power, and I will default this to 2, then connect this to the exponent. Now I will just seal this, so we can get nice smooth lines like this. So now I will just select all of this and call this sprites. So now all you have to do is, from the outlines, just drag and type in max, and now connect this to the B. You can also use an add node, but then you have to clamp it if you don't want it to go above 1, because when this one value and the one value from this overlap, it will become 2. With the max, even if they overlap, it will only become 1. So now we can just connect this to the alpha here and click apply. So now we have these sprites. So now we can increase the power to decrease the size of the sprites. We can also increase the line amount to 100. Now we can decrease the power. Like this. So now we have sprite like this, and we can also individually change the colors. So yeah, that's it for the tutorial, guys. Thanks for watching, and if you want to support the channel, check out my Patreon. The links will be in the description below. Thanks.